In 1831, Darwin, then 22 years old, set sail on a 5-year survey expedition for the British Empire. He journeyed from England on the HMS Beagle, traveling around the southern tip of South America, then north toward a chain of volcanic islands in the Pacific called the Galapagos.
Moving through history in an unguided and undesigned way, the theory of evolution.
Excuse me?
Yes, Ben.
How did life begin in the first place?
Mr. Stein, you have the same question every time.
Well, you never answer it, sir.
It develops, you know, we've been through this so many times, you have
to. Could there have been an intelligent designer? What was so bad about intelligent design?
Intelligent design people are not genuine scientists.
Intelligent design is a racket.
It's just propaganda.
The only intelligent thing about it is to have got people to call it that.
It's really very stupid as well. Huh? Everybody knows science education in America is appalling. What we don't need at this time is intelligent design in the classroom.
If they have a way of understanding nature that's superior to the one that we all are making lots of discoveries using, great. Bring it on.
A lot of things went right on Earth to have yielded complex life, absolutely.
The number of factors that have been postulated has grown. Currently, the typical number you would see is, in a typical list, would have something like 20. If every element has to be there at the same time, you have to multiply the probabilities. And that's what makes the probability at the end so small. You've got 10% of this and 10% of that, and these things rapidly multiply to exceedingly small numbers. The numbers on the order of 10 to minus 15, which is 1/1,000th of 1 in 1 trillion. And it's a number like that that you have to compare to the 100 billion stars that are in the galaxy. 100 billion is a very large number, but 1/1,000th of a trillion is much, much smaller.
Evolution is a fact. It's a fact which is established as securely as essentially any other fact that we have in science.
Well, then who did create the heavens and the earth?
Why do you use the word who? You see, you immediately beg the question by using the word who.
Well, then how did it get created?
Well, by a very slow process.
Well, how did it start?
Nobody knows how it started. We know the kind of event that it must have been. We know the sort of event that must have happened for the origin of life.
What was that?
It was the origin of the first self-replicating molecule.
Right, how did that happen?
I told you, we don't know.
So you have no idea how it started?
No.
There are many probabilistic resources in the galaxy, but on the other side of the coin are all these factors that you need. You have to get just right in order to have just one habitable planet like the Earth. And that leads me to conclude that yes, we're rare in the galaxy.